Exercise 3.11.2c of my book Introduction to Physical Hydrology. Let's take a look at the water balance of a polder. A polder is a low-lying area below sea level from which we have to pump out the water in order to keep our feet dry. We have a polder area of 5 square kilometers. The polder is made up of open water and of a land part. 2 square kilometers is open water and 3 square kilometers is land. We have a precipitation of 750 mm per year, open water evaporation of 600 mm per year, and an evaporation from the land part of the polder of 420 mm per year. The pumping discharge is 2 × 10⁶ cubic meter per year, and we have a storage coefficient for the land part of the polder of 0.4. The storage coefficient is defined as the ratio of added or extracted water depth by precipitation or evaporation in millimeter and the accompanying change in water table level in millimeter. So the storage coefficient is a dimensionless number. Determine the seepage in millimeter per day for a year in which the water table and open water level have risen by 200 millimeter. How do we go about solving this? First of all, draw a cross section of the polder. To the left, we see the open water and the open water level. Through the right, we see the land and the water table. The open water level and the water table are the same. Incoming is precipitation and upward seepage from the groundwater. Outgoing is the open water evaporation from the land, and the water which is pumped out of the polder. So our water balance equation reads as follows. Precipitation plus seepage are the incoming terms equals the actual evaporation, which is made up in part of the open water evaporation and in part of the land evaporation, plus what is pumped out. And then we have delta S delta T, the change in storage during the year. If this is a positive number, it means that your water table and your open water level have increased. And if it's a negative number, it means that you have a lowering of your water table and your open water level during the year. First of all, we can change from square kilometers to square meters, as you see in the above line. And how do we go about solving this water balance equation? Didactically, it's best to start off by using volume per time units. Precipitation, we have this as a length per time unit. Multiply this by the area of the whole polder, the total area of the polder, and you will get an answer for the precipitation in cubic meter per year. Evaporation is slightly more complicated, simply in the sense that we have evaporation from the open water and from the land part of the polder. So take your open water evaporation as a length per time unit, multiply this by the area of your open water, and you obtain your answer for your open water evaporation in cubic meter per year. Similarly, for the land evaporation, which we have as a length per time unit, multiply this by the area of your land part of the polder, and you obtain an answer in cubic meter per year for your evaporation from the land. Add these two together, and you will have your answer for the evaporation for the total polder, for your actual evaporation. What has been pumped out is already in cubic meter per year, so that's easy. We also know that the open water and the water table have risen by 200 millimeter during the year. We also need to establish the change in storage for our water balance equation. And this also is in two parts. We have a change in storage for the open water part and the change in storage for the land part. The change in storage for the open water part is your 200 millimeter per year, or 0.2 meter per year. Multiply this by the area of your open water and you obtain an answer in cubic meter per year. For the land part, It's slightly more difficult. We need to take a look at the storage coefficient of 0.4, or 4 divided by 10. What does this mean? If we were to have 4 millimeter of added precipitation water, this would cause a 10 millimeter rise of the water table. If we have a 200 millimeter rise of the water table, because it's the same as your open water level. So multiply by 20, 80 millimeter of added precipitation water causes a 200 millimeter rise of the water table. So in effect, we find the equation that your change in storage for the land part of your polder equals your storage coefficient times the precipitation in millimeter per year. 0.4 times 200 millimeter per year gives you 80 millimeter per year, or 0.08 meter per year, as delta S delta T, the change in storage for the land part. Multiply this change in storage, this length per time unit, by the area of your land surface, and you'll get your answer for delta S delta T for the land part in cubic meter per year. Now add the delta S delta T for open water and delta S delta T for the land part together, and you obtain your answer for the whole of the polder: 0.64 times 10 to the power 6 cubic meter per year. Here we have our water balance equation, which we can rewrite to obtain the seepage. We know all the numbers, we can insert them, and we find as our answer 1.35 times 10 to the power 6 cubic meter per year. Divide this by the total area of the polder and you'll get your answer for your seepage: 0.27 meter per year, which is 270 millimeter per year. And we want to know the seepage in millimeter per day, so divide 270 by the number of days in a year, which is 365, and we obtain our answer: 0.7 millimeter per day for the seepage. We could have solved this exercise much more quickly by using length per time units. This goes as follows: precipitation is already a length per time unit, 750 millimeter per year. The actual evaporation, for the whole polder, we find as the weighted average of your open water evaporation and your evaporation from the land part of the polder. So take into account that your open water is 2/5 of your total area and that your land part of the polder is 3/5 of your total polder, and 2/5 times the open water evaporation plus 3/5 times your evaporation from the land part gives you your actual evaporation for the whole polder as 492 millimeter per year. Pumping discharge, divide this by the total area of the polder, and then you get your answer in a length per time unit, 400 millimeter per year. The open water and the water table have risen by 200 millimeter during the year. So your change in storage open water is 200 millimeter per year. Your change in storage for the land part involves the storage coefficient, as we've seen before. Storage coefficient times the precipitation gives you your change in storage of the land. And now, same as with the evaporation, we have to use the weighted average, because we have a change in storage for the open water part and for the land part. And we add these together in the same fashion as we did for the actual evaporation, and we find our answer: 128 millimeter per year for the change in storage for the total polder. Here we have the water balance equation rewritten in this form. We insert all the numbers that we have and we find our seepage is 270 millimeter per year. Divide this by 365 and we obtain the same answer: 0.7 millimeter per day for our seepage.